Whoa. You have more light?
Oh, shit.
Or it's enough?
Shorter.
You're sweating.
I'm sweating. Oh, I have this sauna in my head.
Okay.
Okay. First of all, Martin, who is Martin Reithoff?
Who?
Who is?
Was Martin Reithoff is my colleague, also an assistant coach here, and I heard he was a good football player. I heard about this topic. I don't know if it's true or not, but I think if I see him in the training sessions, he still have a very good touch on the ball. So I'm sure that he was able to be a very good footballer also.
Matthias is just an inspirational young man to work with. Fantastic, good ideas on the pitch. A lot of creative minds and know everything about the style we have here in Brøndby, how we are playing, what the philosophy is and which mentality we should bring into the team. So it's very nice to work with him. In the games, sometimes Alex asks us, where are we right now in the games, and what are your thoughts about the situation at the moment? It could be Matze or it could be me, he asks. And sometimes, of course, we're sitting on the bench talking about if we could change something and bring it on to Alex, and then he can take it or not.
Also, I think the relationship to the players is it's easier when you have the experience as a player, because you know how they felt in some situations or in the training. So you have a better feeling sometimes what they're thinking, what they're feeling, and I think that's important. Yeah, I think we both try to bring our experience as a footballer, of course, as a professional footballer in the training, in the team, but also the mentality, the good atmosphere. We need a good combination between the players and the trainer staff.
So I have a cooperation now with Bent Christensen, and of course with the masterclass coaches, especially Frederik in under 19. I'm over there one or twice a week, discuss training exercises and discuss the philosophy we have in the first team, because this year as a strategy also with the 6.4, we want to improve the things in the masterclass, and so that we could see a little bit more of the signature in the first team. We would also like to see that a little bit in the masterclass. So I'm over there making some training exercises, some talks with them, and try to get the philosophy a little bit down to the youth department.
I think we have to try that they have still the self confidence in our training, because they are young and they don't make a lot of thoughts about the training and stuff like this. So they have to stay in the
comfort zone, because it's really important. Most of the young guys have only tried to go up, like meaning that when they are in the youth teams, they are used to winning most of the games. They are not used to sitting on the bench. Of course, it's mostly the best players coming from the youth department or to the first team to train, and they are not used to defeats, and when you come up here, you meet defeat straight away, because of course it's another environment, everything goes faster, Alex demands a lot, and this transition between the youth department and the first team is really important, and that's what we are trying to have a little bit more focus on and try to develop that, so the young players maybe mentally is a little bit more strong when they come up. I love the mentality in the team and also the philosophy about high pressure, giving the opponent not that much time on the ball, take away their time and space and go forward, playing football offensively and try to make as much situations where we can make goals.
For me, it was easy to handle the philosophy as a trainer, because I played in this style of football. And so maybe it's a good start as a coach to begin with this philosophy, but I'm sure that I will never change the philosophy as a trainer, because I totally agree with this style of football, and so for me there's no other way to play football.